Hi everyone, welcome to this new video. Before I start with the voiceover, which I've done already, I just wanted to take some time and thank you for the overwhelming feedback from my Sunday's video, which was the ring pour, which did not really turn out as the ring, but as a great ring pour. I was really overwhelmed about the amount of feedback that I received, and I think I've never had any of my artworks that received that much feedback, especially when it comes to YouTube and Facebook. So it had so many comments, it was really amazing, and I'm really, really grateful for all your comments and feedback and how much you actually loved it. So I was really, really happy about this, and I wanted to share this with you, and just a big thank you from the bottom of my heart. So let's continue with this video. This is the second part, as I told you in my last video, and yeah, enjoy watching. This is just a very short video, I guess. I just finished the wing pour and I had a ton of paint left, as I told you in this video. In case you did not see this video yet, you should really watch this. The end result was just gorgeous. It did not turn out as a wing, as I hoped to, but it really was a gorgeous end result. So I really recommend you watching this. And you can see my messy desk here. I still have the drip of paint from my last pour here, and I do have the cups with the rest amount of paint. I just decided to make some more pours with the rest amount and, yeah, basically the paint that was dripped off. I often do smaller pours to test out new things, new paints, new techniques. And of course, not all the time those turn out as pretty. So I keep them, of course, and just be able to reuse them whenever I want to. So there is no really need to waste your canvases. So if you made a pour and you do not like the result, just let it dry and reuse it once you feel it. So I grabbed 6 of my smaller canvases, and those are all 15 by 15 centimeters, so really small ones. And I just covered them with the drip of paint, just to have a base layer of paint on there to give it a cover up of the paint that is already on there. And in case the paint itself is not enough that I've mixed, I at least have somewhat color to help the paint flow. So the poured paint is going to flow easier over a thin layer of paint than it would flow over a pure canvas, just because of the texture, and as the canvas fabric itself is soaking up the water, it just flows easier when there is a base layer of paint. And this is actually everything that I did here. I put pinboard pins underneath all those canvases just to have them elevated to the surface. This makes your paint easier to drip off, and it will not glue to your desk when everything is drying. And if you put them there, or if you leave them there, you can just use a toothpick or something and go underneath of the canvases just to remove this drip off paint. And you will not have any drip off noses once everything is dried. So I do this myself if I do the acrylic pours, and also if I'm using the resin, just to get rid of those noses. I really find this is a really practical and easy way to get rid of those. When it comes to the pouring itself, this is just a white, a black, and my acrylic gold paint. There is no silicone in there, it is just the paint. So I used my pouring cup, put all the colors in, and just poured it over. I did this technique before on large size, so when I did my marble pour, and I can link the video here in this video as well if you'd like to check this one out. This was the by far largest marble pour that I ever did, and back then it was the first one that I did. I loved the result, and so I wanted to see if I can create something marbly with those colors here as well, which I managed. In the beginning, of course, everything looks a bit messy, as usual, but if you stretch your paints around and see that you get a somewhat decent looking result, everything will turn out as great. And if it doesn't, who cares? So it was a reused canvas, and if there one or two are failing and do not look as pretty, just let them dry again and reuse them as often as you want. As long as your paint layers dry evenly and thin, everything is cool. If you have some chunks of paint and you get some kind of texture on your canvases, you will see it through in the very end, which is not so much of a deal if you have no problem with texture at all. But if you like to have a smooth end result, you might not want this. You can, of course, sand it down and reuse it then, but I don't know if you would like to spend that time for it. Up to you, I guess. So yeah, this is actually all that I wanted to show you, and that you can reuse your canvases. I'm pretty sure most of you do that already. And yeah, this is just the result that I got. And I turned 6 mediocre or bad canvases into, I hope you agree, 6 pretty ones. So as mentioned in my previous video, I've put those in Etsy as a set. If you'd like to adopt those, I would be proud and happy, of course. And if you want to try this yourself, just give it a try. So I hope you liked watching this video, although it was a quicker one. If you're new to my channel and want to get notified when new videos are coming up, please make sure to hit the bell icon and subscribe to my channel. It will really mean a lot to me. And also give me a thumbs up if you like this video. If you'd like to help my channel grow, please share it with your friends on all the social media that you have available. And as always, I look forward to read all your comments. And if you have questions, please make sure to ask them in the comment box as well. So thanks for your time, thanks for watching, and I hope to see you in my next videos. Have a great day. Bye bye.